Madam Speaker, before I reply, I'm getting a lot of members asking me to donate some time. So what I'll do, I'll donate 1 minute each, 5 minutes randomly, one to Ngeno.
I've already put the question and the members and the answer from the members and the eyes have it. So please let us do move your
so I just move
your reply, okay. So that okay. We can move.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Okay, I'll go ahead and move the reply. Madam Speaker, I want to start by thanking all the members of this House for overwhelmingly supporting this bill. Madam Speaker, with the bipartisan spirit exhibited in this House, in this bill, and the trust I have in the 11th Parliament, I'm confident that this bill will be passed. And that it will bring a positive change to the people of marginal areas of our country. Madam Speaker, I have to say that we are not doing a new thing, I think, in marginalized areas. This is something that has been done in many developed countries and still continues even in those very, very developed countries. Australia started this emerging equalization fund, and it's still going on. Canada actually puts a lot of money into equalization fund, the equivalent of Uganda's GDP, about $15 billion a year, billion. There is something I want to point out, Madam Speaker, the perception that's out there that equalization fund is a county fund. I want to say it's a wrong perception, and it's actually a creation of the CRA. The CRA was mandated to make recommendations on marginalized areas as stipulated in the Constitution, Article 204, Subsection 2. It clearly refers as marginalized areas. It is only the CRA that has assumed that a marginalized area can only be a county. And that is why we brought up this bill, because we feel that constituencies are also areas as referenced in the Constitution. And I want to say that CRA erred in that respect by always thinking of counties as the reference area of the equalization fund. Because the Constitution is very clear, it only refers to marginalized areas. And I want to say that even within counties that are well developed, there are marginalized areas that exist within those counties. I've had time to ask CRA why they had referenced the county as a marginal areas. And all they had to say, they did not dispute what is stipulated in the Constitution of Kenya. All they had to say is that it's too much work to go down to constituencies. But I want to tell CRA today that this House is in the opinion that constituencies are the best way to devolve this money to. And I also want to tell them that your job was to do work. And for you to minimize your workload just to put the equalization fund into the county level is wrong. I also want to tell our governors and the media and everybody out there that we are not trying to take money away from the county government. For those of us who sit in the budget committee, they know very clearly that in the division of revenue bill, we have different funds for different areas, and we have county fund and national fund. And it's clearly that in the budget of Kenya that the equalization fund falls within the national government. Article 204, subsection 2 is very clear. That is, the national government shall use, and I want this to be very clear, the national government shall use the equalization fund. And for that reason, the equalization fund is a national fund, and we are not trying to take away anything from our good governors. We are not. We have not interfered with any county fund. We are only asking the national government to give us the equalization fund so that it can be operationalized at the constituency level because of the good work that CDF has done. So I want our friends in the media to get this one as well. That we are not taking any money from the county government. We are asking the national government to give us this money that is the national government's revenue fund to be taken to the constituency level. The constitution is very clear that it's a national fund, and it actually goes further in other sub-articles to refer that the national government may, and that's the only time that the constitution mentions a county within the equalization fund framework, that the county government may, and I want to stress the word may donate the equalization fund to a county as a grant. That is the only reference. But we are asking the national government in this respect, in this bill, to give this money directly to constituencies. And we have a reason to do so, Madam Speaker. We have seen what CDF has done in across our country. We have seen in where I come from. And it doesn't matter your relationship with your former MP, or whether you are a good friend, or whether you are, you know, you've had a good fight during elections and, you know, you're not good friends no more. But the truth today in our country is that if you go to the remotest part of our nation, if you find a dispensary,
Honorable Lelit, what is your point of order, David Gikaria? Are you on a